Hello friends, you're with the Lonesome Gamer, and I'm playing Italia. And, well, until now, the yellow player is actually doing pretty well. He's in the lead. He's doing pretty well with his, some raiding actions. The red player is also fine. The Romans are developing fine, and the Greeks had also are also doing well, fairly well, I think. But the blue player, I'm pretty sure he has a problem. Sometimes it's hard to see in this game because the points alone. They might not be the best indicator here because kind of each power has its own rounds when they should make a lot of points, and then other rounds when it's just to expect that they are not too strong. I'm not sure if Carthage is not doing really bad because they have their hands full defending themselves against the Greeks in Africa. They don't really manage to expand here in Sicily, neither in South Italy, and they've already lost some of these islands up here. So, yeah, that's not very good. Okay, now let's go on. This is now one of these turns. At the end of the turn, I think most, if not all, nations will gain points depending on what they control. So that's definitely going to be interesting then. Okay, the Celts, they start now this turn with 5 infantry in Helvetia, but first they make some income, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bucks plus a city, so that gives them 6, so that brings them up to 9. Okay, they need Picenum Pavia. Pavia is here. Picenum is over here. Yeah. Ravenna, Pisa, Florentina, Verona. Verona, Ravenna. Pisa is easy to get. They might try to grab that. And, well, they also get something for other regions. If they kill a leader, they would gain 5 points, so they might consider attacking Quintius Fabius here. That would give them a lot of points. So let's see. First we can buy 2 units. That will bring us down to 1 then. And well, let's see, I think we can place 1 here. Well, attacking Verona is tough. Hard to tell if we really want to risk that. And 1 here. And then we get 5 more. In Helvetia, which is up here. And we could now use these to attack Verona. Hard to tell if it's worth it. I mean, I get also points for killing Illyrian, so therefore it might be a good idea. Yeah, I get a point for killing Illyrians. 2 points for killing Romans. I could raid the city, that would also give me a few points. Hard to tell. Okay, I'm gonna try it. I think I'm gonna move in here. Attack with 4 units. I'm not allowed to do with more. I'm gonna move this guy down here. Wait a second. I'm gonna attack with 4 units. Ravenna. Although there might be a stacking limit, I'm gonna check that. Okay, so these marsh areas have actually the same stacking limit as standard areas. Only the mountains have this limited have a stacking limit of 2. So then I'm gonna move with this guy into here, to Pavia. I'm gonna move with, now there's a risk involved, but I mean, yeah, okay. I'm gonna move with 3 guys down here, trying to raid the area. And then I think I will at least move with 1 guy here into Liguria. Yeah, okay. Now, as you can see, lots of battles going on now. And I think I want to start here with the raid. So we roll 3 dice. We got 2 Etruscan units here. Okay, it was a successful raid, and the Etruscans did not any damage. So we end up here in Pisa now and raided this area. That gives us 3 victory points. At this point, the Etruscans can discard 1 unit and reconstruct the city. And that's what they're gonna do right away, because in this way they don't lose that income point. Then we will see the battle here. Yeah, I'm gonna fight here against the Romans with 4 dice against 2. So let's do the attack first. We got a -1 modifier here, so this is not easy at all. Okay, but we do a hit. Pretty cool. The Romans rolled 2 dice. They got a +2 modifier, though. So that's also a hit. Okay. Now that gives me quite a few points killing Roman units. Should remember that. The problem now is the Romans, basically they want to retreat, but they cannot retreat in areas that are controlled by subjugated powers, so there is simply no place for them to retreat. They got to fight on. And now we got 3 dice for the attacker One die for the defender. Let's see. And yes, that's an attack. The Romans didn't make it here. So that means a Roman leader is killed and another Roman legion is killed. That's a lot of points here for the Celts. Finally, and I'm going to place this guy here as a reminder for the raided city here. And finally, we're going to do the attack here. This is completely even. So we got 4 against 4. First the attack roll. Wow, not bad. 2 hits. A defender. Well, that's a single hit for the defender here. Okay. And now at that point, the Illyrians could retreat. And, well, I think they actually want to. They move to Aquileia. It's kind of painful, but... So, yeah, the Celts really did good during this turn. And their only weakness is now Pavia. There is only a single unit here. Still, I think, yeah, that might end up as a problem. Still, they did very, very well. They gain lots of points here. Let's see. That's turn 3, by the way, and the Celts gain 5 points for killing the Roman guy, 3 points for raiding the city makes it 8, plus 4 points for the 2 Roman units is 12, plus 2 points for the Cimbrians. Wow, that's insane. That's 14 points. Only for the kills and the raid, and then they will probably gain even more points because of controlling areas, but that's what they get at the end of the game turn. But at the end of their nation turn, they will gain now these, I think 12 points, right? I'm gonna check it, and but I'm pretty sure it was 12. It was actually 14 points. That's just an amazing result, fantastic turn for the Celts. Actually, that might be an important step in the direction for victory. Absolutely great. Okay, then it's the Etruscans, and let's see what they do. 1, 2, 3 plus 3 cities, so that's 6, but they are subjugated. That means, as you can see here, they're subjugated to the Romans. That means they only get half their income, the other half goes to Rome, so it's 3 for the Romans and 3 for the Etruscans. Okay. Now, what want the Etruscans? What do they want to do? Well, maybe they want to get Pavia, and actually they want to. And here I think the Celts made a mistake. They should maybe not. Yeah, but if they wouldn't have left, if they would have left more units there, they probably would not be able to score all these points. So therefore, it might have been okay. Yeah, the Etruscans, they want Pavia. That gives them 4 victory points. And they want the cities there. So they definitely... The problem is if they... I mean, it's really hard to do, right? If you move in there, or if they move in there... to hit, it's a -3 bonus, a malus, so they need a 10 to hit. Now this is extremely tough to do. And it's also kind of unlikely that they can hold the city there for a while, so I'm not sure if I really want to do that. Otherwise, it's really hard to tell, because if I don't do it, it's really hard to say. I mean, okay, we can hope for a lucky roll, so why not? Let's do it. I mean, there are not so many other options. First, I'm gonna buy 2 units here, one here, another one goes here. Well, I could also place another one here, I guess. Yeah, I think I wanna do that. Okay, so we're gonna lose. Wait, is it possible I was only at 6? Yeah, probably. So that means I can only buy 1 unit. So that means I'm now down to 2. And then, yeah, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna move over here, do an attack with 3 dice, and maybe I get a lucky roll. I need a 10. We'll see about that. So, I got a 9. That's not enough. 9 minus 3, that's just a 6. That's not enough. The other guy rolls a 7. That is enough to destroy one of my units. And, yeah. Now it's the question, do we want to continue the battle or not? Oh boy. No, I don't think so. I'm going to retreat. I'm going to move back here. Here's a stack of 3. Here's a stack of 3. These suckers are pretty threatening. So I think I'm going to move back and try to hold what I already have. Okay, so that's then the end of the Etruscan turn. The Greeks, well, they gain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. That is their income. That brings them to 8. That allows them to buy 2 standard units. Which is possibly a good idea. They could attack the fleet here. They got a plus. This is pretty potent. Killing the guys here and these Carthaginians, that would give them 4 victory points. That's pretty strong. quite some units over here, though. Hard to tell. Okay, so the Greeks. Agathocles stays alive during this turn. They will buy 2 units, which brings them down to 0. And they're going to place one here. And, hard to tell. Basically, I need cities to to get points for these areas. I don't get the points for only controlling areas, but I want cities to do it. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place another one here for now. And then I'm gonna take him aboard a ship. And we're gonna then attack here. I'm not sure why the Carthaginians didn't attack Rome here. Maybe they should have done that. But it's a little late now. Now it's gonna be very hard for them. If they die, the Carthaginian player will also have problems to do an invasion against Italy simply because he's out of ships. Okay, let's see. Now, basically because of the leader, all these suckers have a +2 modifier. That ship, because there are 2 units in there, has a +4 modifier. And this one, overall, and this one has a +3 modifier overall. These two have only their +2 modifiers. So let's see. First I'm going to roll for the one with the +4 modifier. And I need a 5 here. And I make it. Then I'm going to roll for the one with the +3 modifier. And that's also a hit. And that's already enough. Both ships are sunk. Carthage can fire back though. They got these 2 ships, and they all have a +1 modifier because of their, the people, the infantry in there. But they didn't do it. So that means 4 points here for the Greeks for killing Carthaginian units. That is a lot. And that point, we'll see if Carthage finds a way to come back and maybe grab now the island. I mean, we'll see about that. Okay, the Samnites. They got two spaces. That gives them 1, and the Romans another 1. And, what are they going to do then? Hard to tell. They could try to attack the Greeks. Here in Lucania, for example. That seems like a good option. 2 units here, so, they might want to do that. I think I'm going to do it. I'm going to attack the Greeks here in Lucania with all these guys. You see, does that give me any advantage? I want Neapolis, Samnium, Calabria, Apulia. Well, not exactly, right? But wait a second. Oh yeah, 1 point for Lucania. So I'm going to try it. Maybe I'm lucky. I got an advantage here. 3 versus 2. So let's see. Well, that wasn't great. Will the Greeks retreat? Hard to tell. They might. Do the Sand Knights get points for killing Greek units? Yeah, point. So maybe it's a good idea to retreat here. Hard to tell. It really is. I think I want to fight another round. Okay, now that's not so bad. That's an attack. That's a success for the Greeks. And of course, now we continue the battle. And yeah, actually, 2 more successes for the Greeks, 1 for the Sand Knights. So that means the Sand Knights get a point, but in the end, the Greeks managed to hold Lucania. But for the Greeks, I'm afraid it's not worth any victory points without being a city. So, but still, you know, it stops the Sand Knights from spreading out even further. Next, we see Carthage. Okay, let's find out. There we are. So no special reinforcements for Carthage. The leader dies. That's a problem. Okay. They have an income of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Still very high income. $10. But what do they want to do with that? They want these islands. They want Sicily, I guess. Do they want to risk an invasion here? Well, I think so, yes. Two points for each area in Sicily? No, that's not true. For Lilybaeum, they don't get that many points, only 1. 3 points if they control the whole region of Sicily. They also would gain points for controlling Regium. I don't know, I think grabbing whole Sicily is too risky. Okay, I bought a fleet and an elephant. I spread out here, try to regain control of North Africa completely, simply for some money reasons. And then I'm gonna take the 2 elephants and move them here to Regium, doing an invasion there. I got the supremacy here. The Greek force is not adjacent to this area. I got a -1 modifier because of the mountains. The Greeks have a +2 modifier because it's an invasion. The supremacy, the naval supremacy brings equals the -1 out again. So in the end, I don't have a modifier, and the Greeks have a +2. So So let's see. Yeah, okay, the Greeks did a hit, but I did a hit too. So that means I control now this area down here. And lost my elephant, sadly, but okay. And I gain a victory points for killing the Greek there. So after Carthage, it's the Illyrians up here. I got three areas. That's not enough to buy me anything. Huh. Now, I'm in a pretty bad position there. I don't see really that I want to risk an attack. If I lose too many troops, it's going to be very hard for me to regain money. So I think what I'm going to do is simply I'm going to move back, grab another region, and hope for the best. Okay, finally, it's now Rome. Maybe the Illyrians get something special, I forgot that. It's possible, sometimes they do. It's turn three? Nope. Okay, so now it's Rome, and we'll see. Marcus Curius and Decimus Mus with four legions in any Roman-controlled area. That's what they get. At the end of the Roman nation, turn three, Decimus Mus is removed. Marcus Curius is placed in any Roman-controlled area with three legions and one city is received. Okay, so that's quite a bit. There's, yeah, quite a bit going on. So let's see, first we count the money and we have a nice income now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 makes it 13. We already have 4. So that brings it to 17. That is a lot. Okay, I built myself a consular legion and two standard legions. One standard legion goes here. Remember, I can only build up to... I mean, I can never have more than half the number of consular legions equal to... No. I can have the number of consular legions equal to half the number of the cities I control rounded down. So at that point, because I control five cities, I can only control two consular legions. And I want that one somewhere else, maybe in a battle up there. So then I'm going to take these guys here and I'm going to place... Yeah, I think another one here. And then I get the reinforcements. Two leaders, Marcus Curius and Decimus Mus, with four legions in any Roman-controlled area. I think not everyone gets four legions, but they are kind of divided or something. So... There is Decimus Mus and Marcus Curius. This is this guy here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, there we go. So what do we want to do? Well, I think basically we want to fight the Celts. That's what we should do at this point. So let's see. I'm going to use this guy here, placing him Rome with two, and I'm gonna place the other guy. Probably here. And now this is not a campaign nor a major invasion. So we are kind of limited in our options. Still, I'm gonna grab this guy here, move him here, and then attack right there. Although there is a risk involved, I might actually simply do an attack against this area here. And then I'm gonna move these guys. Nah, is that really what I wanna do? I'm gonna move him here to Pisa, and I'm gonna move two of these guys, and they also end up here. Or will I move him here? Hard to tell. Yeah, I'm gonna move him there, and I'm gonna move one of these guys right here. That sucker is moving in here, and these three guys are also moving in here. So we got three battles now. We start with that one. The other guy, the Celts, have a +2 modifier because of the invasion. I got a +1 modifier because of this naval supremacy. The black ones are the Romans. And the Romans didn't make it, the Celts didn't make it either, but the Celts will actually retreat at that point. Yeah, that's simply too risky otherwise. And I'm simply gonna move back in here. Then we see a battle here. Okay, so we got now three Roman legions with a +2 modifier against three Celts with no modifier. And the Romans are the black guys. And they got, actually they did three hits. That's a 5, a 6, and a 7. The Celts did a single hit. And I think they only get the points for killing units, yeah, if it's the Celtic turn. So that means no points here for killing this Roman legions, and the Celts are destroyed. That was quite a hit. So they lost Pisa. And finally, we will see the battle here. Three Celts in Ravenna, two standard legions, and a consular legion. So the consular legion is the black one, the standard legions are the white ones, and they have a modifier of +1 because of the marsh, which is a modifier of -1. And the leader, oh, that was a very bad roll actually. The Celts can fight back with 3 dice. Oh, and we got to decide now who's attacking whom. They, yeah, I think they're going to attack the weaker ones. All three are going to attack the weaker ones. And wow, it's actually 3 hits. So that's not looking good for the Romans now. Now at that point, the Romans could retreat, and maybe they should. I think that costs them victory points, though. Retreating is tough for the Romans. They would lose 2 victory points if a Roman leader retreats. On the other hand, I think they actually cannot retreat, because they cannot retreat in They're allied territories. I would check that, but I'm pretty sure that's not allowed.
Okay, well, actually, they cannot retreat, so they have to keep on fighting, and this is going to be tough for the Romans. So they have a single attacker here, and we'll see what happens. Okay, they are destroyed. They managed to kill one Celtic unit, but the Romans actually lose their leader and their consul and legion. That is quite a surprise. And yeah, sadly, no points here for the Celts, although they fought that bravely. It's also kind of interesting because now at the end of the Roman turn, Decimus Musus removed Marius Curius and is placed in any Roman-controlled area with three legions. So I guess he is actually not placed. Only the three legions are placed, I assume. So this guy goes away. And let's take the legions and place them. Well, I guess we simply place them here in Rome. And well, that was definitely a surprise. Celts are really doing well. And this is now the end of the turn. And it's going to be interesting to see how many points now everybody gains. Okay, we start with the Celts. And they gain 14 points. Plus turn 3. They control Pavia. That gives them 2 more points. So 16. They control Ravenna. And Verona. That gives them overall 2 more points. So that's 18. And half a point for each other, for any other area. Okay, so that means 18, 19.5 points. That's extremely, extremely impressive. Absolutely amazing for this turn for the Celts. Just fantastic. Okay, let's follow this order here. Oh shit, it's not here, it's here. So the Etruscans, well, they're not that great. They only managed to get, I cannot see, turn 3. Oh fuck, I forgot to give them 2 infantry. Well, I'm going to give them 2 infantry now. Not sure that would have changed so much, but yeah, I should have done it. I'm going to place one here and another one here. No, they go into a single area, I think. So I'm going to place them here. Okay, fine. Or on the other side. I'm going to leave them there. So, let's see now. Yeah, there they are. Okay, 4 points for the cities of Perugia and Pavia. Well, they don't control any of them. Pavia is controlled by the Celts, Perugia by the Romans. 2 points for the cities of Picenum, Etruria, and Ravenna. Well, at least they control Etruria and Picenum, so they are at 4 points. 1 point for each other city, so they get another point for that one. That gives them 5 points. But because they are subjugated, they only gain half the points rounded up. So the Etruscans only gain 3 points, which is not very good.
Carthage. Well, that's a point for killing a Greek unit.
Plus, well, at least no Greek units in North Africa. 2 points for Messana, Syracuse, Regium, and Agrigentum. Okay, they control Agrigentum, Messana, and Regium. So that gives them 6 points, plus one is seven. 1 point for Lilybaeum, Corsica, Olbia, and Carales. Well, at least they still control Olbia. It's 8. 3 points for the whole region of Sicily. Nope.
So that means 8 points for Carthage. Well, that's not very good. It's pretty much, I think, it's the least they should have gotten. And considering that the Etruscans had such a bad result, we can definitely see blue falling behind at that point.
Okay, let's see Illyria. 2 points for Ravenna and Verona. Well, sadly, they don't control any of these. Half a point for any other area, including Illyricum. So that means they gain 2 points. Well, okay, not great. But, you know, I mean, they're usually not that strong. They're still existing. They give you a few points and, well, could be better, but it's not, for them, it's not that terrible. Now, what about the Sand Knights? 1 point for killing the Greek guy. And in addition, they control Samnium and Calabria. So that gives them 4 more points. So they are at 5. And apart from that, they don't control anything else. So 5 points for them. But, well, until now they did a good job. And it's a little sad they didn't manage to grab Lucania. But, you know, I mean, yeah, now they're pretty weak. But at the beginning of the game, in the first 2 turns, they did really well and they gave yellow some valuable points. Okay, let's do the Romans now. Well, okay, 3 points. Yeah, they get a lot of points now. For Perugia, Picenum, Samnium, and Corsica. Corsica, Perugia, they don't control Picenum, and they don't control Samnium. So that's 6 points for them. 2 points for, oh, they actually lose. No. Okay, so 2 points for Apulia and Ravenna. They don't control Ravenna. Where is Apulia? That's here. They do control this. So that's 8 points. 1 victory point for each for any other area. Okay, now let's see. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so that means they are at 15 at this point. And then, and this is the amazing thing, they gain 2 victory points for each city. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 12 more. So they gain 27 points here. And yeah, that's it. That's very good, I think. And well, yeah. And finally, we got the Greeks with turn 3. Okay, we got, well, actually 4 points for the Greeks for killing the Carthaginian fleet there, plus 2 points for each area in Sicily or North Africa. So that's Wait a minute. No, that's not true. They gained that in the last turn already. Here, 3 victory points each for the cities of Syracuse, Messana, and Calabria. Okay, so they only control Syracuse. The others went lost. So 2 points each for the cities of Lucania, Lilybaeum, and Agrigentum. They control Lilybaeum. None of the others. 1 victory point each for the cities of Neapolis, Brutium, and Regium. Well, okay, I mean, they don't control that either. And by the way, Agathocles is removed by the end of the turn. Okay, so that means all they gain from these is 3, 5, plus 4 is 9. Well, that doesn't sound so much. Still, until now, I think the Greeks have done an excellent job. They made a lot of points overall. And, well, not that many, but they did a really solid job. Okay, now we see the overall result. For now, blue is fucked. They are at 17. They're doing really poorly. And the Etruscans and Carthage, they're both behind their expectation. Especially Carthage did not well. Yellow is doing really good with 39.5 points. They're doing pretty well. Especially the Celts are still in a very strong condition. They control lots of North Italy there. And not only with a single unit everywhere, but here with 2, here actually with 3. So, and they gain some income now, so they might strengthen their defenses there. So, yeah, that's a... They're not destroyed yet. It's going to be some... There's going to be some work left for the Romans to destroy them. And so 39.5, and red is in the lead with 46 points. They made quite some points now. As I said, I think the Greeks did pretty well during the game, and the Romans also did a good job. Okay, but there's still a lot to come. I have my doubts that blue can come back, but it's going to be interesting between yellow and red. Okay, hope to see you in the next video or on lonesomegamer.com.